Good morning once again, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd 2014. Now, in my first video, we talked about marriage in terms of this gay marriage concept. Now we're going to talk about the gay or homosexual aspect of this gay marriage concept. But basically, we're going to be talking about homosexuality and what the word has to say. Now, I'm not going to justify anything that I say, except I'm coming out of the word. It has nothing to do with my personal feelings or anything like that. I love all of everybody because all and any of everybody has all sorts of issues and sins going on. Just like the Father says, no sin is greater than the other. But we're going to talk about this specific topic right now. So get on board or not. But here we go. Now, here's some of the things you hear, or at least a couple of things you hear that people say about gay marriage. They say, the Bible says that marriage is between a man and a woman. Now, people say that to defend the fact that they don't believe gay marriage is scriptural or spiritual. People also say this, God is against gay marriage. Well, I haven't found that either, but he is clear about what he is for and against when it comes to these two separate terms. See, like I said in my first video, people have married these together and then want to debate it using scripture. Scripture has nothing to do with this fused concept of gay marriage. Like I said before, the term gay and homosexual or marriage, when it comes to scripture, are mutually exclusive terms. The world has made them synonymous with one another for its convenience. The deception by the enemy continues as always, and many buy into it for what? For a lack of knowledge in the word. See, you have to educate yourself. You have to indulge into the word more than you do into the world and all its ideas and concepts, which constantly, continually confuse and mislead people. Now, let's define a couple of important terms to help us clarify before we even move forward in the word. Now, you can expound upon it or take it for the aspect that I'm trying to get across in understanding. The term gay means of pertaining to or exhibiting sexual desire or behavior toward a person or persons of one's own sex. Homosexual means of pertaining to or noting the same sex. So in those terms, it's relatively simple and clear as to what we're talking about. Sexual desire, attraction, or whatever towards someone of the same sex, be it gay, homosexual, or however you want to view these two terms. Now, the concern that people have in the worldly form with the area of homosexuality is not so much the characteristics of someone who is gay, especially men, in so much as people have an issue with the sexual aspect. Now, I get that. It throws people off that much more because it's something that they visualize and they have no way to really rationalize it as acceptable in their mind. So people tend to push things to another level when they get into these gay/homosexual discussions because that's what a bigger part of their brain has focused on, the idea of the sexual aspect. But the Father's clear in his word about all the aspects of it. Now, in fact, scripture also addresses effeminacy in men. But first, let's define what an effeminate is. Effeminate is a man or boy having traits, tastes, habits, etc., traditionally considered feminine as softness and delicacy. Now, this is what the Father addresses in terms of gay, homosexuality, effeminacy. This is what the Father addresses. And take note, people, that without one being allowed, the other is not possible. If A is not allowed, then B doesn't exist as an option. in the heavenly kingdom or even as a discussion in Scripture. This is why Scripture doesn't address gay marriage. The Father addresses homosexuality, effeminacy, bestiality, and all these things in no uncertain terms. He's direct and straight to the root of it. If he doesn't allow that, then how can marriage be even an idea worthy of discussion in Scripture? It's not. He cuts it off at the root, like I said. Leviticus 18, 22 through 24 reads like this. It says, "Thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is abomination. Neither should thou lie with any beast to defile thyself therewith. Neither shall any woman stand before a beast to lie down thereto. It is confusion." Now, see, the Father says that lying with like kind, us people laying down with the like kind of ourselves is an abomination and it is confusion. And he also says doing the same with animals is an abomination. In Leviticus 20:12, it reads, it says, "And if a man lie with his daughter-in-law, both of them shall surely be put to death. They have wrought confusion. Their blood shall be upon them." See, he says that they have worked confusion. That's what wrought means. They've brought, or they've worked, they've created confusion. Verse 13, "If a man also lie with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death. Their blood shall be upon them." See, the Father doesn't gloss over anything. He cuts right to the chase. He says, I don't care how you dress it up, he says homosexuality is not tolerated. He is against that. Now, if he is against this so direct and firmly in his word, how can marriage become part of a discussion? It can't. He cut it off at the root, but people have dragged Scripture to this to try and make it that type of a discussion, and it's not. Now, back to Leviticus 18, 24. 24 reads, it says, "Defile not ye yourselves in any of these things, for in all these the nations are defiled which I cast out before you." Now, these Scriptures I was reading in Leviticus, they go all the way back during the time of Moses. See, the Father was so specific that he pointed this out, homosexuality and all these things out, to the people, the children of Israel. He warned them as he freed them. He said, pay attention to this. This stuff is going on before you. It is not tolerated. It is an abomination. This is the same thing that was going on before the flood during the time of Noah. They were creating and doing all sorts of things, bestiality, all that. And the Father wiped the whole world out. And here we come all the way up to the time of Moses. And yet, here we go with the same thing all over again. And the Father chose his people and said, look, this is what's going on. I am not tolerating this at every level. It is worthy of death. So he was serious about this. Now, this is coming straight from his word. And don't think that it's changed. He was serious about what he said. Now, let's go to a scripture that people often say, well, it doesn't really say what people are saying it says. It's just kind of unclear as to what it's really saying. And to that I say, really? I think people need to study Scripture. Go with me to Genesis 19:5 and read it. It reads, it says, "And they called unto Lot and said unto him, where are the men which came into thee this night? Bring them out unto us that we may know him." Now, some people say that's unclear as to what it's talking about. Really? Okay, well, at the point where it says, we may know him, there's a reference. See, the reference for those who aren't sure what the word is saying, because the word always is clear. The Father is clear in his word. He even gives us this reference. And the reference is what? Genesis 4:1. And it reads, it says, "And Adam knew his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord." Now, the word says Adam knew his wife and she conceived. Well, if he knew her and she conceived and she bare a child, it's very clear that they had sex, clear and simple. So to know someone, if we go back to the scripture that people often refer to, Genesis 19:5, when it comes to Lot, when it says, send them out so that we may know them, these men in Sodom are saying, send them out so that we may have sex with them. It's clear. That's the Father's word. It's clear. People, you got to study the word. It's there. All the answers are there. Now, let's move on and address one other scripture, 1 Corinthians 6:9. This got Phil Robinson in trouble when he made reference to this because the political correctness of the world didn't want to hear it and still doesn't want to hear it. But this scripture addresses the effeminate along with other things. Verse 9, it reads, 1 Corinthians 6, verse 9, it reads, know ye that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind. What's that talking about? Nor abusers of themselves with mankind. Okay, people can say it's ambiguous and unclear if they want, but we can find more scripture to tell us exactly what it's talking about. But the Father's word is clear about what he says. He says, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revelers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. It's the Father's word. It's clear, straight to the chase. People can't get upset and angry at people because they say what the Father has mandated that we know and understand and share with the world. Well, people can get upset, but it's not going to change the facts. All that's going to do is put to task people like Phil Robinson, like I said, and his family. And people like me and anyone else who aren't afraid to say what the Father's word says. See, we don't have to dress it up. We don't have to use our own words. Just read what the Father's word says. It says what it says. Now, one thing, understand people, we are mandated to love all our brothers and sisters. The word is clear about our associations and dealings with the worldly also. Now, just because someone is a drug abuser, that doesn't mean that I don't love them or I shouldn't love them, but it does mean that I have to be careful of my associations and all sorts of other things. It means that I don't go hang out with them at the crack house just because I love them and they're my brother. See, you don't go out and tempt the devil in his area of expertise where you are weak at best, thinking you can handle it. See, people get in trouble every day thinking they can handle situations because they know and love the Lord. But the Father is clear about some of the things we need to be aware of and not subject ourselves to also. So I need not burden myself with being a judge or punishment that comes therefore. That's the Father's job, and I thank him for keeping that type of burden off me. See, the world addresses what it addresses specifically, but the point is clear that the Father is not going to allow sin in heaven. When he looks upon me, Phil Robertson, you, anyone else, he doesn't see us as individuals. He sees sin or no sin. See, but when we go through him, we can overcome whatever it is that ails us in the area of sin. Like I said, his word lays sin out. It doesn't matter how we got here. See, people spend too much time focusing on who, what, when, where, and how they got into their situations, be it homosexuality, be it drugs, be it addictions, vices, whatever. People spend too much time focusing on that and trying to figure out or make excuses or justify it instead of just saying, you know what? The Father says in his word, all things are possible through him. See, whatever ails us, we need to get over it, go through and to the Father and let him heal us through him. Because if we don't work through him to eradicate the sin in our lives, and I don't care what it is, we are not going to see the kingdom. His word is clear. These things are not going to be allowed in the kingdom of heaven. So, to wrap it all up, gay marriage is a worldly thing. There's nothing heavenly about it. It's not even addressed in scripture. Two separate issues. The Father is clear about both. Gay marriage is a worldly thing that the world has dragged and mixed in with scripture. That's work of the enemy. So, with that, check your feelings and move your toes. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.